Welcome to Strength of Materials, Numerical on Compound Stresses. In this numerical, we have a two-dimensional stress system has a tensile stress of 600 megapascal and compressive stress of 400 megapascal acting on two mutually perpendicular planes and two equal shear stresses of 200 MPa on these planes resultant on a plane which is inclined at 30 degrees we need to determine and with respect to x-axis and the magnitude and direction of principal stresses. Clear? So let us see the solution for this. So in this part we can see the solution of this particular problem. So, solution, first we will draw the two-dimensional system. So, two-dimensional system is this way. Now, let us draw the stresses. One is tensile stress. This is tensile stress. And one more is compressive stress. So, drawing the tensile stress. Compressive stress in y-axis. So, this is compressive stress what we are going to draw in y-axis. So, now we can name them like this. This is sigma x. This is also sigma x. This becomes as the sigma y and this becomes as the sigma y. Clear? Now, we have the two mutual perpendicular stress as the two equal shear stresses which is of 200 megapascal. So, shear stress will be acting in this direction. So, let us see. This particular part will be the shear stress which is going to act. This is tau x y, the particular value that has tau x y. Clear? Now, we need a particular 30 degrees and resultant stress on which the 30 degrees will be given. So, before that, what is the given values? Let us write on the particular part of the given values that are sigma x is equals to particularly value is 600 megapascal, that is Newton per mm square, and sigma y is equals to, that is acting in the compressive stress, so it is minus of 400 Newton per mm square, this particular value. So, then we have the value of tau xy, which is equals to 200 Newton per mm square. Okay, so let us see what is the particular part we have to do. So I'll just draw this particular two-dimensional figure once again. So let us make it more clear. So a bit large and large size the particular figure if we draw, so I can make it more clear for you all. So, this particular, so we have the x, sigma x acting here, sigma x acting this way, then sigma y acting in the downward direction, sigma y acting in the upward direction. Clear? Now, we required the 30 degree angle what we have to take. So, I will take with a different color so that you can easily understand the 30 degree plane. So, now see, the 30 degree plane is going to with respect to x-axis they have mentioned, with respect to x-axis. So, with respect to x-axis means this particular is y-axis, with respect to x-axis is this one. So, this is the particular x-axis. Okay. So, with respect to x-axis we have to draw it. So let us draw with respect to x axis. This will be acting in this direction. So it is acting in this direction, the x axis. Clear? So angle is how much for this? So angle is 30 degrees. This is 30 degrees. Okay. Now we know that y direction angle is also acting here. This way. What is this total angle? This total angle will become as the theta value. This total angle will become as the theta value. Now we know that this is particularly x axis. So this much is 90 degrees. So remaining this angle is how much? 30 degrees. So total the theta value will become as 90 plus 30 degrees, which is equals to 120 degrees. So with respect to these all values, we need to calculate the further part of the things. So this is what we have to remember. So I repeat that these values, which is, this is sigma y, this is sigma x, here it is again sigma y, this part is again sigma x. Clear? So sigma y value we have to take minus 400 and sigma x value we have to take it as 600. Clear? So going further for the next part. So in this, what values we can see, find out. So first of all, I will write the formula. So the formula is for the particular values, what we know is, so we have sigma theta is equals to sigma x plus sigma y divided by 2 plus into bracket sigma x minus sigma y divided by 2 cos 2 times theta minus tau x y sine 2 times theta. This is first equation what we are going to determine the value. Okay. So writing sigma theta, we have the sigma x as 600. Okay. So substituting 600, minus of minus plus, so this is plus here. So that is plus into minus, it will be minus 400 divided by 2. So let us put this part in bracket, plus this value sigma x, that is 600, minus of minus plus, so this will become as plus. Here sigma y is 400 divided by 2. Now cos 2 times theta value 120 degrees minus tau xy is 200, already known to us, so substitute 200 sine of 2 times 120. Okay, so substituting these values and calculating, once we calculate, we get the value of theta, sigma theta is equals to 23.205 newton per mm square. Clear? Then we will calculate tau theta. Tau theta, that is sigma x minus sigma y divided by 2 sine of 2 theta plus tau xy cos of 2 theta. Here, this is the equation to find out the theta, that is the principal shear stress, which is acting with respect to 30 degrees. Okay. So substituting the value of sigma x. Sigma x is how much? 600. Minus of minus plus 400 divided by 2 sine 2 times 120 degrees plus tau xy 200 into cos 2 times 120 degrees. Substituting this and calculating with the calculator, we get the value of sigma theta as minus 533.012 Newton per mm square. So we have the two values, sigma theta and another value sigma tau theta, as this way. So we got the two values as this particular part. Okay, so this particular values we are going to consider. Now we will find out what is the resultant. Okay, so first part is resultant stress. So resultant stress, that is sigma r is equals to square root of sigma theta square plus tau theta square. So we know the sigma theta value, we know the tau theta value. Substituting that into the square root, so this is 23.205 value square plus this is minus of minus, so it will become plus, but I'll put it here in the bracket, minus 3.012 whole square. This is under square root. So substituting and calculating the values, we get the sigma r as 533.516 Newton per mm square. Clear? So we got this particular part. Now this I need to form it into the figure. Okay, so this I need to form it into the figure means what we have to do it. Clear? So this much part we have known. Now we will see how much the figures what we have to do. So this is the first part. This is the first part. Now I'll put this part into the particular figure. Okay, this is what is the thing. Okay, so this particular two-dimensional force, that is two-dimensional system, so we have this as 30 degrees perpendicular. So 30 degrees angle. So where will be the shear stress and where will be the particular part if we are going to see? So we can see that this particular line, whatever the perpendicular to this particular plane. So this is the plane now, this particular perpendicular plane. So this perpendicular plane is like this. So this will be the sigma theta. We can see the sigma theta value. And this is sigma theta. This is the tau. Tau I'll draw just a moment. So tau value is this way. This is tau theta. Clear? This particular value is tau theta. Now the resultant part, what we have seen, the resultant is of these two resultant, these two forces, the result. So resultant will be acting in this direction. So this is sigma r value. So we can see this particular part of value as the sigma r value. Okay, so this was the first part of the problem. Now let us move for the second part of the problem. In the second part of the problem, they have asked us to find out the principal stresses. So principal stress which is given by the formula as sigma x1 comma sigma x2 is equals to sigma x plus sigma y divided by 2 plus or minus half of square root of into bracket sigma x minus sigma y whole square plus the 4 times tau x y square. So this is the formula for finding the principal stresses. So substituting the values which are known to us, sigma x 600 plus of minus, minus will become 400 divided by 2 plus or minus half of square root into bracket 600 minus of 400 minus, that is plus, it will become as 400 square plus 4 times 200 square tau x square. So this is the square value. So we get two values here usually. So this part which is becoming as 600 minus 400, that is 200, 200 divided by 2 is 100. Once we will take plus value, so taking plus value, substituting and calculating this particular value, we get the one value is 538.51, so which is equals to 638.51 newton per mm square, which we will take it as sigma x1. Okay, then coming for sigma x2, second value, it is 100 minus 538.58, which is equals to minus 438.51 newton per mm square. So this is sigma x2. So we got the two values. Now we have to determine what is the direction of the particular plane. So direction we can find out. So let us see the direction. So direction, I will solve this particular part here. So direction of principal plane is, so how it is given, tan 2 theta is equals to minus 2 tau xy divided by into bracket sigma x by sigma y. So substituting this value, we will take minus 2 into 200 divided by into bracket 600 minus of minus plus, it will become so 400. So when we divide, we get the value in minus, so that is tan of 2 theta is equals to minus 0.4. Yeah, so what we have to do in this particular part. Okay, so this is the negative value. So we have two values here. One is sigma x 600 x1 and this is sigma x2, and this is tan 2 theta value, so direction of plane stress. So finding that particular part, we can see a small note here. So note is what, if tan theta is negative, okay, then actual theta can be formed by using this particular formula, theta is equals to tan, sorry, not this one, I'll make a small correction here. So that is the formula will become as like this: theta equal to 180 minus tan inverse of positive theta. Okay, so how we are going to write 2 times of theta is equals to 180 minus tan inverse of 0.4. Clear? So moving to this part, 2 theta is equals to 1. So this calculation, once we do, we get the value as 158.198. Okay, so therefore theta P1 first value we get. So 158.198 divided by 2, whatever the value we are getting, that is 79.09 degrees, first one. Then one more, that is theta P2 is equals to 90 plus theta P1, which we are taking it as 90 plus 79.09, which is equals to 169.09 degrees is the value of sigma theta P2. So this is the first numerical what we have seen, determining the values of particular plane stress and plane stress degrees. Okay, moving to next numerical. So this is the second numerical what we are able to see this. So in this numerical we have a particular question: a certain point at a strain material, the values of normal stress at a right angles to each other planes are 80 megapascal and 32 megapascal, both tensile, both are under tensile. Now this is the first part we have to remember, and the shear stress of 32 megapascal. Clockwise it is, clockwise. So the rotation comes here clockwise. So if it is anti-clockwise, we need to understand on the plane carrying 80 megapascal, clockwise on the plane carrying 80 megapascal. Okay, determine maximum and minimum normal stresses. Normal stresses means what? Principal stresses only. Normal stresses means principal stresses, and locate their planes and also calculate maximum shear stress and its plane. Okay, so what all is to be determined, let us see. So solution part. So considering for the solution, so we are going to write the solution. So this, so in this part we have to draw the first particular two dimensional element. So drawing the two dimensional element. Okay, so both are under tensile, as it is mentioned, both in tension. One is 80 megapascal, one is 32 megapascal. So sigma y, sigma x, sigma y. Okay, so this we are writing sigma y, this we are writing sigma x, sigma x, and this as sigma y. What are the values? So values we will write here. Sigma x is equals to, both are under tensile, means positive, 80 newton per mm square, and sigma y is again tension, so that is 32 newton per mm square. Then we have the tau value. Which is the tau value? So tau, I'll show, it is clockwise acting, it is acting clockwise. So clockwise means we will consider in this direction tau. For clockwise we need to this direction, this will take a rotation of clockwise. So here it is tau value, this is tau value. Okay, so with respect to x-axis, this is clockwise rotation, that is tau xy, this is again the tau xy. So what is the value of given tau xy? It is 32 newton per mm square. So this part here, don't get confused with 32 because this is sigma y, this is tau x y. Okay, what all we have to determine? So we need to determine the normal stresses, that is sigma x1 comma sigma x2, then theta p1 and theta p2, then tau 1 and theta s1. Okay, these values we have to find out. This s is what? Shear stress and shear stress its plane. So this we need to determine. Okay, so let us start with this particular point. We can mark the boundaries as A, this as B, this as C, this as D. Now here there is no inclined angle they have given. Okay, so no inclined angle they have given means we can easily directly go for the particular part of the problem. Okay, moving. So let us write down. We have, what is the formula? Sigma x1 comma sigma x2 is equals to sigma x plus sigma y divided by 2 plus or minus half of the square root into bracket sigma x minus sigma y whole square plus 4 times tau xy square. This is the formula. Substituting into the, and one more formula is what? Of the angle, that is tan 2 theta p is equals to minus 2 times tau xy divided by into bracket sigma x minus sigma y. This is the value. Then tau max is equals to the formula as tau 1 we will take, that is the tau max half of square root into bracket, that is sigma x minus sigma y whole square plus 4 times tau x y square. So this is the value. Then the one more formula is tan of 2 times theta s is equals to, so that is sigma x minus sigma y divided by 2 times tau xy. So this formula in the reverse order. So let us start the solution with the particular formula. First one, we will find out the sigma x and sigma y. So sigma x1 comma sigma x2 is equals to what we have to write. So that is 80 plus 32 divided by 2 plus or minus half of square root into bracket 80 minus 32 whole square plus 4 multiplied by 32 square is in the square root form. Okay, writing this particular values, we get this one value. So this particular value is how much we can easily find out. So that comes out about to be 56, and here we get one value, plus or minus square root half of square root 2304 minus 4096 squaring. Then square root is done, 56 plus or minus half. So into bracket here I will take this value after root plus and square rooting. This comes out about the 80. So we have the two values as 56 plus or minus of 40. So doing two these values, we get one value as sigma x1 is equals to 56 plus 40. We get this as 96 newton per mm square, and one more sigma x2 56 minus 40, which is equals to 16 newton per mm square. So these are the two values, sigma x1 sigma x2. Clear? So now moving to next part. So here in this, the next part is what? Tan 2 theta p, which is equals to minus 2 times tau xy divided by sigma x minus sigma y. Okay, so substituting these values, minus 2 into 32 divided by 80 minus 32. So these two values, when we substitute, we get the value as particular the thing, the formula of this when we substitute and we are able to find out the particular value is in this way format. So we have the particular value of, so I'll write it, tan 2 theta p is equals to minus 1.332. so 2 theta p is equals to 180 degrees minus, as stated, negative can be taken as positive, 1.332. so 2 times theta p is equals to 126.876. so theta p 1 is equals to 126.876 divided by 2. So theta p 1 is equals to 63.438 degrees. Then the value of theta p 2 is equals to 90 degrees plus theta p 1, which is equals to 90 plus 63.438. so this we can take as equals to 90 plus 63.438. so theta p 2 is equals to 153.48. so we got two values, one is theta p 1, one more is sigma p theta p 2. So now let us see related to the part of the things. So the remaining part of this particular problem, let us see. So now we can find out that particular the plane, that is tau 1 is equals to half, that is it is equals to tau max value, the square root of sigma x minus sigma y whole square plus 4 times tau xy square, this value. So when we calculate, substituting the values, half square root 80 minus 32 whole square plus 4 times into 32 square, substituting this value, we get the value of tau 1 is equals to 40 newton per mm square. So this is the particular value. Then we are going to calculate the part of tan 2 theta s is equals to sigma x minus sigma y divided by 2 times tau xy. Substituting in this, 80 minus 32 divided by 2 into 32. So we get this particular value, that is tan 0.75. So this we can write as this also, 2 theta s is equals to tan inverse of 0.275. So we can say that the 2 times theta s will be equals to 36 point particular value. When we take it the things, we can say that the value as 36.8 theta p1 is equals to p1 theta s is equals to 36.86 divided by 2, which is equals to 18.43. Now we need theta p1 minus theta s. What is the value? So that is 63.438 minus 18.43, which comes out to be 45 degrees the value. This is the particular.
In this third numerical, so what all are the given data is 120 megapascal of tensile stress and 90 megapascal of the compressive stress is given on elastic material, and they have given the maximum principal stress is limited to 150 MPa. So they have given us one value of maximum principal stress. So we need not to find out the maximum principal stress. We need to find what is the corresponding shear stress with respect to these two values, and one more, that the what value will be the maximum shear stress at a point, that we have to determine. So let us see the solution for this particular part. So solution is this way, that we need to first show you what is the figure, how it is going to have the forces which is acting on that particular two dimensional body, so that it will be more clear for you people. So now, so इसको देखो अभी ये क्या हो जाएगा, यहाँ पे दोनों तरफ से आपको फोर्सेस आएंगे, एक टेंशन है और एक कंप्रेशन है. सो जो कंप्रेशन है, कंप्रेशन अंदर की तरफ आएगा, कंप्रेशन अंदर की तरफ आएगा. सो ये 120 वाला टेंशन है और 90 मेगापास्कल वाला कंप्रेशन, ठीक है. तो हम क्या करेंगे, ये वाला सिग्मा वाई है और ये सिग्मा एक्स है, ठीक है. तो हमें टाउ एक्स भी चाहिए, तो टाउ एक्स हमारे पास नहीं है, टाउ एक्स को फाइंड आउट करना पड़ेगा. तो टाउ एक्स एक्ट कैसे करेगा, सो टाउ एक्स विल बी एक्टिंग, ये इस तरह से एक्ट होगा टाउ एक्स. अगर हम देखेंगे कि टाउ एक्स कैसे एक्ट होता है, तो टाउ एक्स विल बी एक्टिंग इन दिस वे. सो इस तरीके से टाउ एक्स एक्ट होगा. यहाँ पे tau x, सो ये हो गया tau x एक्शन. या सो अभी हम क्या करेंगे, इसको फाइंड आउट करेंगे कि क्या वैल्यू हमको लेना है इसके हिसाब से. सो पहले हमारे पास क्या क्या है, सो सिग्मा x है जो कि 120 न्यूटन पर mm स्क्वायर, और सिग्मा y है दैट इज माइनस 90 न्यूटन पर एमएम स्क्वायर, एंड टाउ एक्स हमारे पास नहीं है. सो टाउ एक्स इज इक्वल्स टू हाउ मच, व्हाट इज गिवन, द मैक्सिमम प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेस. यहाँ पे हमें क्या दिया है, एक मैक्सिमम वैल्यू दिया है, मैक्सिमम प्रिंसिपल स्ट्रेस जो कि वैल्यू है 150. सो हम क्या करेंगे, मैक्सिमम प्रिंसिपल का वैल्यू लेंगे, सिग्मा एक्स वन इज इक्वल्स टू 150 न्यूटन पर एमएम. So, ये n है न्यूटन पर एमएम स्क्वायर, और हमें और क्या फाइंड आउट करना है, सिग्मा टाउ मैक्स फाइंड आउट करना है जो कि मैक्सिमम शेयर स्ट्रेस, ठीक. तो इसके लिए हमारे पास दो फॉर्मूलाज है, एक फर्स्ट फॉर्मूला हमारा है सिग्मा एक्स वन इज इक्वल्स टू सिग्मा एक्स plus sigma y divided by 2 plus half of square root into bracket sigma x minus sigma y whole square plus 4 times tau x y square, okay, first formula, or sigma tau max ka ek formula jo hai, this is the formula, that is tau 1 karke lenge half square root of sigma x minus sigma y whole square plus 4 times tau x square. So this is tau max formula. So substituting the values in this formula, iske andar humko formula mein ye values dalkar, ye wale values iske andar dalkar humko calculate karna hai jo values. So pehle karenge hum sigma x1 is equals to sigma x plus sigma y by 2 plus half square root of sigma x minus sigma y whole square plus 4 times sigma tau x y square. So is formula ke andar hum values. So sigma x1 ka value hame malum hai jo ki hai 150 equals to sigma 1 x ka value kya hai 120. ये माइनस है क्योंकि माइनस 90, तो ये प्लस क्या हो जाएगा, माइनस 90 हो जाएगा. तो यहाँ पे हम लिखते हैं माइनस 90 डिवाइड बाय 2 प्लस हाफ रूट ऑफ ब्रैकेट में 120, माइनस का माइनस प्लस हो जाएगा. सो यहाँ पे प्लस 90 स्क्वायर रूट प्लस 4 टाइम्स, यहाँ पे हमारे पास वैल्यू नहीं है टाउ एक्स स्क्वायर का, तो वो वाला वैल्यू हमें फाइंड आउट करना है. तो अभी करेंगे इसको फाइंड आउट वैल्यू. सो 150 वैसे ही रहेगा लेफ्ट साइड. सो 120 माइनस 90 करने से 30 आ जाएगा, 30 डिवाइड बाय 2 करने से. सो ये हो जाएगा हमारा टोटल वैल्यू कितना, 15. सो 30 डिवाइड बाय 2 ले लेता हूँ प्लस हाफ रूट, ये आ जाएगा 210, 210 स्क्वायर प्लस 4 टाइम्स टाउ एक्स स्क्वायर, अभी भी अंडर रूट में है. इसके बाद दिस इज 15 इक्वल्स टू 15 1 बाय 2 स्क्वायर रूट 210 स्क्वायर प्लस 4 टाउ एक्स स्क्वायर. Yeah, ये हो जाएगा हमारा वैल्यू. तो इसके हिसाब से भी हमको सॉल्व करना है आगे. सो अब क्या करेंगे, 150 माइनस 15 आ जाएगा, ये वाला इस साइड जाएगा, ये वैल्यू इस साइड चला जाएगा, तो माइनस में आ जाएगा, इक्वल्स टू हाफ स्क्वायर रूट 210 स्क्वायर प्लस 4 टाइम्स टाउ एक्स स्क्वायर अगेन. क्लियर? सो ये वैल्यू हो जाने के बाद, सो इसमें क्या 150 माइनस 15 हो जाएगा, तो कितना बचेगा, ये 135 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 2. अब क्या होगा, ये वाला वैल्यू इस तरफ चला जाएगा, तो यहाँ डिनोमिनेटर में ऊपर जाएगा तो न्यूमरेटर में. तो ये हो गया, 1 से मल्टीप्लाई हो जाएगा, ये रहेगा ऐसे ही. तो यहाँ पे क्या बचा, स्क्वायर रूट 210 स्क्वायर प्लस 4 टाइम्स टाउ एक्स वाई होल. अब क्या करेंगे, इसको हम टोटल कर लेंगे. सो 150 मतलब ये 260, 270 इसका स्क्वायर रूट. तो इसको पहले डाल देता हूँ, 335 इंटू 2 इसका स्क्वायर रूट इज इक्वल्स टू 210 स्क्वायर प्लस 4 टाउ एक्स स्क्वायर. तो इसका जो स्क्वायर रूट है, ये वाला इस तरफ चला गया, ये स्क्वायर रूट इस तरफ चला गया, तो ये आया यहाँ पे स्क्वायर. नाउ वी विल कैलकुलेट द फर्दर वैल्यू, दैट इज दिस पार्ट, टाउ एक्स वाई इज इक्वल्स टू, ओके, सो टाउ एक्स वाई स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ 270 स्क्वायर रूट माइनस 210 स्क्वायर divided by 4. So tau xy is equals to 84.852 newton per m square. So this is the value of tau xy square. Yeah, so ये वैल्यू हमें मिल जाता है. इसके हिसाब से हम आगे करेंगे तो हमको एक सही तरीके से ये मिलेगा. सो लेट अस गो फॉर द नेक्स्ट पार्ट. अब हमको क्या फाइंड आउट करना है, अभी हमें फाइंड आउट करना है टाउ मैक्स, मैक्सिमम शियर स्ट्रेस. ये क्या है, मैक्सिमम शियर स्ट्रेस term is equals to tau 1 equals to, that is, half square root sigma x minus sigma y whole square plus 4 times tau xy. So substitute karenge iske andar value half square root, kya hai x ka value 120, minus of minus plus ho jayega, plus 90 whole square plus 4 times tau. Tau का value हमने find out किया है, कितना है 84.85 square. So this substitution calculation करेंगे, tau max का value मिलेगा हमें, कितना है 135 newton per mm square. So इसी के हिसाब से हमारे पास दो values आ गए, एक tau xy का, that is 84.85 newton per mm square, and tau max का value 135 newton per mm square. So 1 second. So these are the two values what we have got. Thank you and see you in the next video.